Falcon High School. Here are today's announcements.
A new class is coming to Falcon High School called the Butterfly Club. If you want to help grow butterflies, join us on April 1st in the art room at 2:30.
Don't forget, on Friday, there will be a senior class photo at Hamilton Park during lunch. Remember to wear black.
It's perhaps using seniors. Keep exposed to colors. These are the results of presenting outside persons. So save up and get your money to Mrs. Mary and Jane the Gas.
There will be a blood drive at the end of April, April 22nd to be exact. Sign-up times are between 8:30 and 1:30. If you have any questions, go to room 114. We'll be mostly upperclassmen as donors, and you need to be at least 16 years of age.
Just a friendly
reminder, our school is trying to do our part to help Ukraine. The girls' soccer team is holding a fundraiser to collect essential items for the people of Ukraine. You could donate medical, hygiene, adult, child care, and food items. Donations will be brought to room 105 until April 7th. If you have any questions, you can go to Ms. Capisi or any members of the girls' soccer team. Some major news from the Oscars on Sunday night, as actor Will Smith walked up on stage and smacked the host, Chris Rock, after he made a rude comment about his wife. Debates have sparked around the world over whether this was staged or real. Smith has since apologized to both the Academy and Rock on Instagram. The Academy is doing a formal inquiry to determine if Smith should be banned from future Oscar nominations. What do you think? Canada has qualified for the World Cup for the second time in the country's history, with a 4-0 win over Jamaica on Sunday. The last time they qualified was 36 years ago in 1986. According to the Women's History Month info, Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg will posthumously receive the Great Americans Medal. Her children, James C. Ginsburg and James S. Ginsburg, will accept the medal. If you're interested in celebrating Ruth Bader Ginsburg's contribution to gender equality and human rights, you can register virtually through the Smithsonian Institute. On this day in 1981, Ronald Reagan was shot and wounded at a failed assassination attempt. This was only 2 months after his inauguration. The shooter, John Hinckley Jr., served his sentence in 2016 when he was released with many conditions and now lives in Williamsburg, Virginia. Don't believe us? Look it up.
That's all we have for you.
And I'm Nora Waleed.
Thanks for watching.